There have been a few questions regarding uploading and downloading to a Notifier panel using VeriFire tools. So let's see if we can make a video and help with that. This is to show you how to upload and download to Notifier Onyx fire alarm panels. Start by opening your VeriFire tools program. Next, plug in your USB cable at the top of the CPU. You'll get a ground fault on the system when you plug in the USB cable. You'll click local area network to populate the panel. Next, go to Online Services and click Upload Download. Once you see this screen, select the node in the upper right. And if you don't already have a project open, you can create a new one by clicking Browse and then say Create New Project. You can enter your project name. You don't need to worry about passwords or descriptions at this time. Then click OK and then click Upload to upload the database into the program. And you'll see the status bar advance. When it's done, open the project. You can now edit the database by opening up the tree on the left-hand side. We'll open up the SLC loops and make a change. In this example, we're just going to change the description on a single device, and then don't forget to click Save on the lower right. Now, if you want to download those changes into the panel, you have to click Upload Download. When you look over here, you notice Uploads available but not Download because you're not logged into the panel. Double-click on the panel in the lower left, and then enter your installer passcode to log on to the panel. Now you have the option to download to the node by clicking here. Then you're going to use the current project, and then click your download. Next, a validation screen is going to pop up. The program's going to check, and if you have any inputs that are not specifically assigned outputs, it's going to give you warnings or errors. You can just click Yes to continue, and the download will begin. The fire alarm display will show you the download progress as it happens, and then it will check the database and reboot the system. After system initialization, be sure to test it to ensure proper functioning. Instead of a USB, you can use a proprietary NUP cable. It's a 9-pin cable on one end and a proprietary connector on the other end. You'll see that it's a keyed connector and it plugs in up at the top of the CPU. Using your NUP cable is exactly the same as a USB cable. Start by clicking your local area network and the panel will populate in the lower left window. You can log into the node by double-clicking in the lower left and then entering the installer password, not the maintenance password. Once there, you can now upload from the node. Remember to click the node in the right-hand box. To create a new file, click Browse, and then click Create New Project. Enter the file name you want to use, and then click OK. And then you can click Upload. It'll download the database into VeriFire tools, and when it's complete, you can open the project. You can also create a blank database and upload the panel data into that. Enter your file name and then click Next. You need to select the hardware type that you're going to be uploading. In our case, a 3030. It has a database version of 31, but we'll choose the wrong one on purpose so that you can see that it doesn't matter. It just overwrites it. You can enter a panel label, and when you're done, click OK, and a blank database will be built. This is your blank database in the upper left. Click on local network so the software can find the panel. You can close that window and then click on the panel to connect to it. Go to online services, click upload download, select the node in the upper right. You'll upload your data into the current project and then click upload. Click yes that you want to overwrite the data. You will see this progress screen as it uploads. Click OK when it's done. And now you have an updated version of the database that you can edit as needed.
We hope you found this video helpful. Please like and subscribe for more content.